Ikutamiti. Ikutamiti. Tada peto di kuta. Kuta is an ancient Owu community. My progenitor founded Kuta. I am a direct descendant of the founder of this kingdom. My progenitor left Orileowu, as it's been called today. Then it's been called Owibole. At a point in time, it's been called Agou during involvement. Owibole was the first Owu state settled by Oduduwa. The Owus are the first grandchild of Oduduwa. That is why some call us the Jews in Yoruba land, because we scattered all around. If you look at the Jews, they scattered all over the world after the Holocaust. The Owu scattered all over the country and diaspora after the disintegration of Owu in 1820. But my progenitor left Owu Igbole. We did not even know really Owu then, because we left 1427 to this present location, to found this present location. In those days, when you are migrating, you don't have the luxury of vehicles or luxuries of aircraft or chopper. You migrate by foot and horses. And Lugua Akindele, the great warrior of Owu, is my progenitor, is the founder of Kuta. Iyazum is going to, after the demise of Ajibos, is his father, Iyazum is going to be the next king. But the oracle chose his younger brother. So he left Owu Igbole. On their way coming, then they believe it is ghost or one pandemic or the other that kills them on the road, because they, as they keep moving after five days or 9 days, or they will stay, rest and move. Whichever places they stop, they will lose one or two people until they reach this present location. On reaching this present location, they rested for 9 days. Nobody died. They look at themselves and search, what is happening? Then, Akindele and Lugua left to weep only with his Ifa priest, known as Atorumokwele. Atorumokwele was shortened to Atorumokwe. He has Atorumokwe to consult oracle, the Sikh divination. That's, have we reached our final abode? The oracle tell them, yes, this is where you are. Death has invaded you. Ikutamiti. At the time I go, Ikutamiti. So death has invaded you. They settled there. With time, evolving of time, Ikutamiti become Kuta. Kuta is an woosted. Kuta is not being settled here by Oluwo or Iwo. No, it's an woosted. We have different history with Iwo. In Iwo, we have some Owus that migrated there, about 33 or more than that compound in Iwo that are of Owu extraction. They migrated there after the war, okay, or during the war of 1820. So we have been here 14 something. So if we are to talk about our history, vis-a-vis Iwo, which is our administrative edge, Iwo is the administrative head and administrative headquarter for ease of civil administration conveniences. You know, native authority, under things there is conveniences that, okay, this is a more cosmopolitan urban places there, where you have so larger number of population, the DOs, the others, say, okay, let's make this administrative. Not because they overload you, but the administration is for administrative conveniences. That's how Kuta history goes. Kuta is an Owu kingdom, an ancient one. From Kuta here, we have the like of Olugbode, Oyeshile Olugbode, an Owu son that I left here to go and become Baale Ibadan, Baale Olubadan. Olugbode is from Kuta, that's Olugbode, is our son here.
Wow, Baale Olugbode.
Yeah. So, you know, you can't take Owu away from Ibadan history.
No, you cannot.
It's what we cannot, if I borrow the street language, take it back. You can't take it back. Owu has virtually half of Ibadan.
Wow.
Used to half. The boundary then, the colonial boundary then, is the Diakbe, some meters after the government house before NTA.
Mm.
That's the boundary. Up till today, Owu's have close to 400 compounds in Ibadan. So if you talk of Eromu, many of them left Orile Owu, having known that their brothers, their kith and kins are in Kuta. You know, we have left 1427. Then Owu disintegrate, Ijatare, Ijabomu. Owu disintegrated 1820 and started going. Some going eastward, some going north, some going westward, because we have Owu in Ilesha, Owu Ekwe, we have in Kwara, Owu Obaloyan, Owu Ishin. Then some goes to Erumu, some goes to Mudakeke, Abekuta, Ijebu. As far as outside the country, in Wadei, and some goes to Lagos. That's how we were scattered. But Owu Kuta is an ancient Owu kingdom. Perhaps the second Owu state, because we've not seen an history that controversial that. That is Owu Kuta for you. An ancient Owu kingdom. Ilu se vaye Owu. Si Owu. Eshe.